This week, our developer advocates will fill you in with what's important and new in the developer news at SAP.
We hope that everyone plans to join us for our live kickoff event on October 6th, right here on our YouTube channel. In this event, we will showcase what to expect from the coming 6 weeks of Devtoberfest, go over the contest aspects, how you can get involved, and what kind of educational content you can expect. Most excitingly, we'll be joined by SAP's own Chief Technology Officer, Jürgen Müller, where he'll give his own insights on year-long learning and also what to expect from SAP TechEd. There's a lot of great new enhancements and improvements to the online virtual event this year, and he'll give you the inside track on all of it during the Devtoberfest kickoff event.
The 2021 Grace Hopper Celebration Open Source Day will be held October 1st, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Pacific Time. Open Source Day is an all-day hackathon including workshops in which participants of all skill levels learn about open source while contributing to projects designed to solve real-world problems. It's also the biggest female-led movement in open source. Participants will contribute code to open source projects. These projects can be in the following categories: humanitarian projects, female-led projects, are just interesting projects that have partnered with OSD. For a project to participate, the project must be identified as either a featured project or a choose-your-own-adventure project. If you are interested in having your project join, please click on the link in the description.
We are happy to share that AppGyver is now available to SAP customers and partners as part of the SAP Business Technology Platform. If you aren't familiar with AppGyver, it's a recent SAP acquisition that provides a no-code platform for the development of apps targeting multiple form factors. And that includes mobile, desktop, browser, and even TV-based apps. Customers and partner BTP accounts in the EU10 region can now provision AppGyver via a booster in the SAP BTP cockpit. Although all developers can also still use the standalone AppGyver trial environment as well. When you use the AppGyver subscription from SAP BTP, you are taken to the new Application Development Lobby. From there, you can directly create AppGyver projects or launch a low-code development optimized version of the SAP Business Application Studio. You can also manage all of your projects from this lobby, regardless of if they were created in AppGyver or the Business Application Studio. We also have some new tutorials coming soon to developers.sap.com to introduce you to the new AppGyver capabilities. Personally, I just ran through that tutorial set myself this afternoon, and I ended up creating a mobile barcode scanning app with them. So be on the lookout for that tutorial series coming soon, and begin your journey learning AppGyver.
Version 1.94 of OpenUI5 and SAP UI5 have been released. Both versions come with improved features of the integrated OData model clients and enhanced controls. SAP UI5, the library that includes SAP Fiori elements, also updated these floor plans to create a better user experience. Talking about OData V4 and SAP Fiori elements, the flexible programming model explorer that we announced here a few weeks ago is now ready to be used. This explorer explains all the options you got to extend SAP Fiori elements for OData V4, and it also includes a sandbox with the source code and running samples of extensions. The best part is that you can modify the source code in your browser and see the changes immediately in the sandbox. Go to the links in the description to find the release notes or to jump to the Flexible Programming Model Explorer today.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So have you ever wanted to create an iOS application using the SAP BTP SDK for iOS with offline capabilities and multi-user support? Well, now you can. A new tutorial on developers.sap.com has recently been released, which shows you all of the steps required to create such an application. It follows a real-world use case where an air carrier uses an iOS application to keep track of vital aircraft information before each flight. The application must support offline, and since it is a round-the-clock operation, the ground staff needs to share mobile devices. The tutorial takes you through initial configuration, provides sample code, and finally walks you through testing your application. Check out the tutorial on developers.sap.com for more information.
SAP Data and Analytics Virtual Forum started this week, and it offers you a choice of three virtual hands-on workshops where you can master your data and analytics skills using your own trial versions of products. Next week, you can join a workshop getting business insights from your data with a Data Warehouse Cloud. In this workshop, you will learn about the many ways in which SAP Data Warehouse Cloud can help you create business data models, including working with SAP S/4HANA data. A week later, you can join a workshop collaborative database development in SAP HANA Cloud, where you will learn how to manage the lifecycle of your development projects in SAP HANA Cloud and SAP Business Application Studio. You will get to know different HDI concepts, when to use which types of HDI database objects, and how to create CAP applications and automate their deployment with CI/CD. Interactive reporting with enterprise analytics and planning in SAP Analytics Cloud will be the final workshop during this event. Join it to learn how to easily use multiple types of data, explore the hidden patterns and relationships within your data, and create dashboards quickly. As always, you can find links in the description of this video.